Hey everybody in CNC Router Tips Group, it's Bill again. It's been a while since I've done an update on the progress with the Tormach, and as you can see behind me, a lot has changed with it. I back up just a hair and let you get a peek at the enclosure and the computer. Now, I've spent a good portion of the last few days trying to troubleshoot the parts to try and make a triple edge finder. And today was the first day that I'm actually getting the feel of this, and now, you know, feeling like, yeah, this is happening, and the parts are going to be good. These test parts are some of the best looking parts I've ever made. There's still a few issues I gotta address before I'm ready to send them out, but you know, we're talking days or hours now instead of you know, who knows, weeks and indeterminate time. So I'm very happy with this progress. I see we got two guys on watching the video now. So hey guys, glad you could make it. I'm gonna point the camera into the machine and let you take a peek at what I just made. Okay, this is a bunch of chips fresh off the mill. You can see we've got the beginnings of a triple edge finder here. I haven't had a chance to clean it off, and I don't have my air hose hooked up yet, so I can't blow it off for you. But wipe it down with paper towel. Okay, one of the tools that we're getting to use on this thing is the Shearhog, which is a single flute index cutter. And this thing is amazing. It removes a lot of material. It's a roughing bit, but you wouldn't guess it by looking at this finish. All of that, with the exception of this surface, all of this around here was done with the Shearhog in one pass. So that's pretty cool. The other tool that I'm using, I'll show you over here. Pardon the mess. That's a Superfly, and that's a facing for doing facing moves. It's a fly cutter, and it's again single point carbide insert. So very cool. I'm still doing a little work on the bevel. I've got an insert cutter for that, and you know, should be able to pop these right out. Hopefully all of the back orders this weekend. So hey, Richard Harper, glad to see you join. Thanks for watching this. So you can see this gets pretty messy, and there's a good reason why you have the enclosure. This is the chips from just one part. So you can imagine what it's like when you're doing a whole batch of these. So that's kind of what's been going on in the shop lately. You know, I hope that the machine's apparently excited. I accidentally turned on the coolant while I was sitting here. You know, I hope this has all been worth it for you guys watching all of this. You know, I don't know if it's boring you or if it's something that you're truly interested in like I am. I mean, it's CNC. Everything CNC is cool as far as I'm concerned. So, you know, I hope this kind of helps out. Now, I'd like to do at some point a video where I just show you all the different stuff that I bought that I thought was worth getting to go with this to make parts easier and better. So, you know, I hope to have that out soon. But for the next 2 or 3 days, my focus is going to be catching up on everybody's orders on the edge finders. So I'm going to take this this part right out of the device. I've got a stop on there, and since this was only a test piece, I'm not worried about it being perfect, because in the real world, when you're machining a part, you never remove it from the fixture until it's done. That way everything stays nice. But you know, like I said, this is just a sample piece, and it doesn't matter if it's perfect. So now that I've got it on the vise, I think I'll be better able to show you what it looks like from a finish. So that thing is just shining, and you can see yourself in it. I'm going to change the tool path a little bit, because I think I can get this all in one pass with the Superfly instead of the two passes I was doing, and that would give it a nicer surface finish. Now here, I've got a little chatter going, and I was pushing the speed limit on that cutter to see how fast and how deep I could go in one pass. And so this will probably get a finished pass with a different bit that's designed for that. Like I said, the Shearhog is a roughing cutter, and it will not give you your final finish. And this is also not down to the final depth of cut that I would use. So, you know, little things, most people wouldn't notice or pay attention to it, but when you have a machine, you take pride in your work, and so that's what it is. Hey, Dave Gatton. Anyway, this is what I've been working on, and, you know, I hope you guys like this stuff as much as I do. So I'm looking forward to getting this done, because I've got two router projects I really want to get to now, and my daughter's building her first CNC router now, so I'm really excited about that too. So guys, I'm gonna take off now, but it's really cool that you at least got to see this you know, after the fact. With the coolant going on, you really can't get a good photograph of the machine while it's working. I've got some video, and I'll put it up, but I'm going to put a camera mount inside of the box that is protected, you know, behind some plexi inside the box. And so hopefully we'll be able to get better video soon. So, all right. Thanks for all the thumbs up, guys. I really do appreciate that. It really means a lot, you know, to know somebody's out there at least seeing what I'm doing. Wow, look at them go. Keith Hurley, thank you. Rich Bartko, awesome, guys. Thank you, everyone. So I'm going to call this a wrap for tonight. If you've got any questions, just leave them there in the group, and I will try and answer them. I appreciate it all. Thanks, guys. Have a good night.